Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to Morgellons Discussion and Microscopy Videos. I'm your host, Jeremy Murphy, and behind me here are some comedo-like masses. We're going to be talking about these worm-looking things and a little bit more today. I would like to be able to get on here and do more videos, but to be honest with you, the shit's kind of hit the fan, and so I'm just doing the best I can to tuck and roll and make sure to dodge and weave. Dodge and weave. The best I can. Because we're all just trying to make it, right? But the question is, what are we trying to make of Morgellons? And to be honest with you, I'm just trying to make it legitimate. And you know what makes that hard? When people don't know what Morgellons is, despite there being a volume of evidence demonstrating exactly what it is. So these things back here, they're not worms, they're not nanotechnology, they're definitely not cocoons. You know, I used to think that these were the white worms coming out of my skin. And I sent one into the laboratory and they studied it. They biopsied it and they did a chemical analysis and they determined that it was a subcutaneous gland. That's true. And what these things come from is overproduction of collagen. And the one thing we know that Lyme disease is capable of achieving is overproducing some collagen. And that goes back to what we want to make of Morgellons. Is Morgellons just this multi-systemic thing that happens alongside Lyme disease? That's not really what the evidence demonstrates. The evidence is quite clear that Morgellons is a skin condition. It's not a disease itself. Lyme disease does just happen to coincide with the onset of Morgellons. Does that prove that's what causes it? I think Occam's razor is fairly thin. And so I think that the margin of error for missing that point that Morgellons is caused by Lyme disease and other spirochetal infections. I think if you're missing that, you're trying to make Morgellons something that it is not. And we don't do that here on this show. I know I'd probably be more popular and people would want to share my stuff around. But, you know, I'd like to take the high road instead and just stick with the facts. And the facts are that these things are not worms. They're comedo-like masses. Do they always occur in light of Lyme disease? No. And not syphilis either. Sometimes they can occur, apparently, from like toxic exposure. I was having some ladies on my Facebook page today. It does happen occasionally. And we were talking about taking too much oxalates. And that can apparently result in these things. I looked it up, too, and they weren't bullshitting me. But these things right here that we're looking at, these are the comedo-like masses, and there's really nothing to worry about when you see them. There could be something wrong, but your doctor should be able to determine what that is to help you to manage these things. But they're not Morgellons. They just happen to coincide with some patient specimens that were being examined for Morgellons. This is a separate condition entirely, and the best I can determine, it's regarded as it's a fucking word, man. God damn it. What is that fucking word? What is it? No, that's not it. What the hell? Let me think about this for a second. See, I should have done this shit in the morning. I think I got it. Here we go. No, I don't fucking have it. What the fuck? Oh, yeah, I got it. Okay. Alright. Acne vulgaris. That's true. That's right. This thing's in the back here that be coming out of people's faces are a condition referred to as acne vulgaris. And there is some literature that shows it's associated with syphilis, but it can be associated with some other things as well. So when you see these, the question is, do they coincide with Morgellons? Absolutely. Absolutely they coincide with Morgellons. Is it every time? I don't know. And I don't know if I can give you a solid answer on that. There may be a lot of Morgellons patients who don't ever experience these. Kind of like there may be a lot of Lyme disease patients that never experience Morgellons. And it would take a little bit more investigation to determine exactly what the percentage is of patients with Morgellons, the skin condition, that coincide with the acne vulgaris. I think it's not going to be 100%. Because I know that Lyme disease and syphilis affect people in different ways depending on their exposure, their genetics, the kind of craziness they have to go through in life, and how the future is looking for them. So, to get beyond this craziness coming out of the skin is going to take a solid foundation built on support, understanding, and honor. And with Morgellons, there is no honor. Because these thieves are literally stealing the definition of a scientific term to suit their personal agendas. And we don't do that on this show. We go by the book. And the book says Morgellons is a skin condition, not a multi-systemic disease. What do you guys think? Let me know. Leave a comment down below. Yeah, I'd love to come on here and do some more videos. Like I said, though, life is throwing the fucking bricks at my head, and I'm doing my best to just duck and weave. Duck and weave. Love you guys. Talk to you soon. Take care, and have a pleasant day.